You text her every single day. You guys hang out 4 to 5 times a week. And you come to me and say, Chris, I need some help. She's losing interest. What can we do? Well, the first thing I'm going to think of is we need to pull back. That's obvious. But the question is, do we pull back fast or do we pull back slowly? And that's what I want to talk about today. Now, I want to talk about the benefits of pulling back slowly. I think what's great about it is, at first, she might not even notice. And then as time goes on, she may start to act a little more interested. She might not even know why. She might not even notice you're doing it, but she's just responding more positively. But over time, she'll start to notice or get like a sinking feeling that I think I'm losing power over this guy. And then she'll be like, no, I'm just imagining things. That can't be. That can't be. I've got him exactly where I want him. But then one day she'll say, no, it's true. I'm losing power over this guy. And I really feel there's nothing like slowly letting her know that she's losing her power. That kind of dreaded feeling kind of creeps up on you and lasts long. Instead of just taking everything away all at once. And then she would be like, oh, okay, he's kind of pulling back. It'll be obvious to her. The problem is if her interest isn't high enough yet, she may just walk away too. She may, oh, he doesn't text me anymore. He doesn't hang out anymore. I'm just going to walk away. And another thing is, for some guys, that's your only access to her, is through text messaging or seeing her once in a while. If you take all that away, then you have no opportunities left to be attractive or be observed being attractive. So we don't want to take everything away. So that would be the case for going slowly, for pulling back slowly. Now, I stand by the principle that if a girl has positive interest level in you at a certain point, you can do anything, right? You can be a super challenge. You can tell her that, you know, that you have to cancel a date, or tell her, maybe I'll let you know if I'm going to meet you. You could do some of the things that women have done to you, and you'll be worried. Oh, Chris, she's going to leave. She's not going to put up with this. And they won't leave. A girl will not leave if she's interested in you at a certain level and you're a challenge. That's not how it works. Women don't say, yeah, I really liked him, but he was too much of a challenge, so now I'm going out with this guy that I can walk all over. It's just not how it works. So going slow has a lot of benefits. Now, that's going slow in terms of how much attention you give her. But when it comes to mistakes, that's a totally different thing. So as you, as a client, come to me, we don't slowly stop your mistakes. We instantly stop them. So things like giving gifts, sending flowers to her work, we don't slowly stop that. We immediately stop that. No excuses, no exceptions. That just instantly stops. Because you don't say, hey, Chris, man, I only confessed my feelings 3 times this week. This is better than last week when I did it 6 times. No, we instantly stop the big mistakes. We don't slowly stop giving gifts. We immediately stop giving gifts. So that's a little distinction that should be clear when you come to me as a client. We're going to look at how fast or how slow we pull back, but we'll also look at the mistakes you're making, and we instantly stop those. So guys, think about it. Should you pull back fast or slow? Well, it really depends on your situation. Think about where her interest level in you is right now. If it's really low, if you're at like zero interest level, she's not thinking of you at all, then you don't want to pull back all at once, right? You want to do it slowly. If you feel that she may be into you, but just not as much as you'd like to be, then you can really pull back a lot, and you can pull back a lot faster because she won't be able to walk away. All right, guys, think about that lesson, and I'll see you guys in the next video.